So we're having a look at the complex world of biomechanics with JJ Rivet, and we're having a look at taking this complex subject and making it really simple so that you can apply what the best players in the world are doing to your game. So JJ has worked with some of the very best players in the world, and he is able to help them understand the complex world of biomechanics and able to make this into simplistic terms within their golf swing. And all of the movement we make in the swing is underpinned by biomechanics. So it is underpinned by the fact that the movement you are making in your body, it has a unique signature to you. But there are principles to biomechanics that we all have in our swing. And JJ is going to talk about those areas right now, and you're going to see how he'll go into a little bit of detail in what those principles of biomechanics are, and then how you're able to start to relate them to your golf swing.
In the fundamentals of biomechanics, you always look first of all at on how the foot is working so far, you know, to be able, you know, to work with the force applying on the ground, and all this force applying from the ground to the body will be able to be transmitted, you know, to the hands and to the club heads. That means all the energy will flow, you know, from the foot to the hand and the club. For that, you need to respect five big fundamentals. The first one is the way you play with the foot, what we call the footworks. Means how you are able, you know, to transmit force, to direct force on one direction on the other. The easiest way, you know, in the swing is to, in the fundamental of the swing, is to have the more simple way to move the force applied on the foot. Means going on a reverse direction, you know, at the start of the swing, to be able to maintain a fixed axis of rotation. So we talk about footworks. The second fundamentals of biomechanics is how you can create energy. Because in every action in sports, you are creating energy, you are maintaining energy, and you are releasing energy. So where you are creating energy is in the backswing. And in the backswing, the key is the muscular energy. We're going to be helping the people to create this energy by coiling. Rotation, a lot of people are talking about rotation, but if you rotate without coiling, you will not be able to create energy. So in coiling, we have something we need to resist and something which is turning. It's like the arch.
Yes.
If I want to bend my my arch and to throw, you know, the arrow, I need to have a fixed point here. If when I'm pulling, you know, the my hand is coming, I have no energy. So first of all, how can I maintain this energy? The lower body will be the key, you know, how the lower body can resist to be able, you know, to have a rotation of the upper body by a concept we call the dissociation, which is the third fundamentals in biomechanics. To respect the dissociation on every part of the body. You have dissociation when you are walking on two opposite directions on the foot. You have dissociation when you resist with the lower body and you turn with the upper body. You have dissociation when you are turning with your shoulder and your head is remain fixes. So all these dissociation will appear on different parts of the swing, and we'll check step by step how they are able, you know, to be maintained or creating or moving. So the fourth one is how you're able to create the release. You have different concepts. People think that, you know, what makes the energy is the left hand. At the end, you know, with the hand which is flexing and extending is the right hand. So a lot in biomechanics, you talk a lot about releasing. And in the golf swing, that's the right hand for a right-hander, which is creating, you know, the extension. So that's going to be the hands will release it. How do you release it? So to be able, you know, to release it, you need to have a strong shoulder blades. How this shoulder blade can be strong? If you move the angle of your body, or if the shoulder blade is moving badly, or if the body is going too quick, the hands can extend. So you have different points, and we'll see after, what are the key elements of the releasing. Are they maintaining? Are they working too quick? Are they working too much? That's what we look after. And the last one is the speed of your movement. To be able, you know, we are not equal on how we are able to coordinate a motion. So the speed of coordination is the fifth one, but certainly the most important one, because it links with the tempo. And the tempo can move, you know, in a career, can move in a month, can move in a day. So how can I keep my tempo? It's going to be how I can keep, you know, the coordination of the different segment I need to get with a certain speed. That's the fundamentals we look after. And you will see step by step how we can respect or not, you know, these fundamentals and their effect on what you are able to create in the swing. Here you have what we call the Hendrix bar. That's the algorithm to recreate the Hendrix bar, which is the bar which is going from the second toe to the heel. And when your weight is moving along this Hendrix bar, you are able, you know, to create a good coiling. If you go outside or inside, you lose the energy you have been creating just before. So the more you stay on this line, the better it is.
So when you've watched the video right there, what you're going to see is that he talks about the Hendrix bar, which is the weight moving straight up and down the feet. So this means that the weight isn't displacing to the sides of the feet here. It is going straight up and down. And he describes it as like a steering wheel. So how your arms would move straight up and down as the steering wheel is moving. So this is what is creating the rotation in the lower body. If you want to see this drill in action, have a look at the Molinari video that we've made, which is a drill that he had been using alongside JJ to help him get the feeling for the load. The next area that he starts to talk about is the coil. Now the coil is actually not what everybody thinks it is. It's in terms of, oh, well, we're resisting with the lower body while we're rotating and this is gonna hurt your back. It's not. The coil that he's talking about is through the ground and it's actually across each foot. So what we're talking about here is as you've made your backswing, that the left foot doesn't roll and collapse inwards. Instead, this stays as stable as it can while the weight has gone back and into the right heel. So you feel the load into the heel and the knee stays as quiet and as solid as it can whilst the left knee hasn't rolled inwards. The more that you can create the disassociation between the movement in the two feet, so going a little bit more towards the front of the left and really into the heel of the right, in this direction here, this is creating the power that you're then able to start to use on that way down. Now, he also talks about disassociation. That is just simply being able to, in normal golfing terms here, be able to move your shoulders as much as you can versus the hips, or the hips being able to separate. It's the separation of the lower body in transition which creates that power. But you can actually then start to look at how we can use this through the floor and how, when you are creating the movement down, so when that left knee goes outwards, that left weight can go towards the front of the left foot this way, and it's pushing, the legs are separating, which means that the upper body will just be slightly lagging behind. So as I get here, that would be the disassociation between the upper body and the lower body, which would be absolutely vital to what we're trying to achieve. Lastly, talk about the release, or the two things, release and the tempo. So the release is just basically where the club's gonna move with you. So we get some players who will release it too early, and that'll be because they've not got their weight shift across enough, and then that'll be led into what they do with their hands, where they will have it. And you'll have the odd person who almost releases or hangs on to it a bit long. Now, he's not talking about encouraging to fire the arms here. It's just getting the movement of the body to work with that, which lets the club release properly. So if you've got a tendency of keeping this club like this, the chances are you've not got the weight moving into the heel enough. As the weight goes into the heel, the body opens up, and that allows that club to release. And the tempo is just actually about how you're able to sequence the body movements in the right order. Because if you do that, then the tempo is actually really good. And one thing that he talked about was giving a little pause in the backswing, because it helps to give them a bit of time So if you actually hurry down and you don't start from the lower body first, it can be a great drill to teach you how to be able to get that timing that you're going to need for your golf swing. So you can see there that all these technical parameters that he's looked at, they're actually really, really applicable to your golf swing. What you'd want to look at is which one of it is the most important. Now, I saw from JJ, he was talking the most about the players not working up and down the Hendrix bar. They don't do that very well. That's the one that he tends to see a lot of people. They get their weight on their toes and they don't load properly. That would be the number one thing that he reckons that people aren't getting right. And that is then they aren't loading that right glute going back. That would be what I would say that most people would probably want to have a look at first, because that then will impact how much coil you can make. And if you have a look at the movement pattern after that, that will then alter how you're able to deliver the club on a consistent basis. If this is something you've really enjoyed, comment below. We're obviously going to try and get more information, more videos with the likes of JJ, because he is absolutely unbelievable in this field. He's the forefront runner of all of this information, and he's ahead of the game. So if it's something you're interested, comment below, and we'll endeavor to make more videos like this.